So fifth sum, very very important sum, star on Q, star on Q. The binary operation is on Q, where Q is nothing but rational number. What is it given? This is a format. A star B is equal to A plus B by 2. A star B is equal to A plus B by 2. This format is very very important format. If we going to make a binary operation of any two element, these two elements should be added and divided by 2. This is a very, very important concept we want to know. If we going to take 1 star 2, what will be the answer? 1 plus 2 by 2. This is the answer. If I going to get C star D, what is C star D? C plus D by 2. This is a format. A star B is equal to A plus B by 2. If we going to make binary operation on any two elements, then I need to add these two elements and divide by 2. This is a very good format. You need to listen. A star B is nothing but A plus B by 2. That's all. This A and this B belongs to Q. You know, this A and B belongs to Q. To examine closure, commutative, associative, identity and inverse. We need to satisfy all the 5 axioms. First, I'm going to take closure. Solution. Take closure. This is one of the biggest sum only, but it's a 5 mark sum. Very easiest sum to write. Closure. How I'm going to write very easily? See. For closure, I told you. What is the formula for closure? A star B. The closure is nothing but A star B is a formula. How am I going to write? This A and B belongs to Q. We know this A and B belongs to Q. If A and B belongs to Q, then we can say A plus B by 2 is also belongs to Q. Therefore, A star B is also belongs to Q. Closure is is true. We can easily say, we know A comma B belongs to Q. If A comma B belongs to Q, A plus B by 2 belongs to Q. If A plus B by 2 belongs to Q, then A star B belongs to Q. Therefore, closure is true. That's all. Therefore, we have got A star B, no. So, next. After closure, I am going to satisfy commutative. This is also very, very easy. By definition, what is the formula for commutative? A star B is equal to B star A. This is a definition for commutative. So, first I am going to take this one, A star B. According to concept, what is A star B? A plus B by 2. This A plus B, I am going to write B plus A. Listen, this A plus B, I am going to write B plus A by 2. This full format, I am going to write B star A. Why? What is B star A? B plus A by 2. See, B plus A by 2. So, we have got A star B is equal to B star A. So, star is also commutative. That's all. Otherwise, star is commutative. I will write once again. Otherwise, commutative is true. By writing closure is true, you can say commutative is true. Otherwise, you can write commutative is true. That's all. Simply you can write. No problem. We have finished 2-1. Next, third one is associative. Next, I am going to prove associative property. First, I write by definition, what is associative property? A star B star C. First two brackets, then A star B star C. Next two brackets. This is very, very important. Listen carefully. First, take LHS. What is LHS? This is LHS. LHS is nothing but A star B star C. First two bracket. This star C leave as it is. Put star C as it is. You know what is A star B? First, write this one. What is A star B? This A star B is nothing but formula we know, A plus B by 2. This A star B is A plus B by 2. Put star C as it is. Now, this is one element. Star C. This is another element. You know, this is one element. See, this is one element. This is another element. If there is two element, we need to add these two elements divided by 2. The same here also. This is one element. This is one element. First, we need to add these two elements and divide by 2. Add these two elements. A plus B by 2 is the first element. Plus C, the second element, whole divided by 2 is equal to cross multiply A plus B plus 2 into C is 2C. 2C by 2 whole divided by 2. Now I need to multiply 2 2s are 4. A plus B plus 2C, 2 2s are 4. So this is LHS. Next I am going to take RHS. What is RHS? See this RHS. A star B star C. Keep A star C. A star as it is. Keep A star as it is. What is B star C? We need to find B star C. B star C is nothing but B plus C by 2. B star C is nothing but B plus C by 2. So this is one element, this one element. First add these two elements. How are we going to add? A plus, this is the first element, A plus. This is the second element, B plus C by 2. You know formula, whole divide by 2. So cross multiply 2 here. 2A plus B plus C, 2 whole divided by 2. 2 2s are 4. So 2A plus B plus C, 2 2s are 4. Check here, A plus B plus 2C by 4. Here 2A plus B plus C by 4. Both are not same. The LHS is not equal to RHS. LHS is not equal to RHS. Therefore, associative is not true. Is not true. Both should be equal, but it's not true. So next, the last fourth one, not last one, fourth one, nothing but identity. You know, by definition A star E is equal to A. You know, by definition A star E is equal to A is the definition of the identity. But you know, identity should be unique. Throw the sum, identity should be only one. A star E is equal to A. So identity should be unique. So what is the formula? I'm going to take A star E is equal to A. What is A star E? You know the formula, A star B is equal to A plus B by 2. The same, A star is nothing but A plus E by 2 is equal to A. Let 2 come this side. A plus E is equal to 2A. A come this side. Because I need to find E only, no. E is our identity element. Therefore, E is equal to 2A minus A. E is equal to 2A minus A is nothing but A. Even though this A belongs to Q, this A belongs to Q, but what is the problem here? See, suppose in spite of A, put in B. B star E is equal to B. B plus E by 2 is equal to B. 2 go this side. B plus E is equal to 2B. E is equal to 2B minus B. E is equal to B. See, for this sum, if I going to take A, answer is coming as A. If I going to take it as B, answer is coming B. This now should become the identity element. Whatever the element I'm going to take here, the identity element should be same. If we're going to take 2, it's going to be 2. If we're going to take 3, it's going to be 3. So it should not come like this. It should not come like this. This is not a proper way. The identity element should be always unique. If you're going to come in as A, throughout the sum, whatever the element I'm going to apply, it should be come as A. But it's not possible. It is not possible. So A, E is equal to A, but identity element should be unique. But identity element is unique. Therefore, E is equal to A, which is not unique. E is equal to A, which is not unique. Therefore, identity is not true. Identity is not true. So next, inverse. What is the beauty of inverse? See, without proving, I can say, if identity axiom satisfy only, I can prove the inverse axiom. So therefore, since identity is not true, since identity is not true, we can't discuss inverse axiom. Since identity axiom, this identity property is not true, we can't able to use the inverse. Why? Because the sum is over here itself. The sum is over here itself. But I need to say, why inverse we can't able to discuss? Because A star A inverse is equal to E. This A inverse inverse element. A star A inverse is equal to, what is E we have found? We have found A, no. For each an element, suppose if we're going to apply A, if we're going to apply B, so each element I can't able to find, because if identity element is a unique, I can apply here. Identity element is not unique, so I can't able to find inverse also. So here we can stop this sum.